sad, right? How do you feel about the time that you've been waiting so far? It doesn't seem very long. When we know we have to wait 4 weeks for an event or until something special happens, it seems so far away. But then, as it gets closer, we just can't believe that it's actually here. But as adults, we know that it is our perception that affects how close or how far away something is. Because logically, it is all the same amount of time. But as we have been waiting, we now have some ideas as to what we can do while we wait. How's your list coming along? Have you given up those two things that we've talked about, of letting go? And how about those three things that we don't want to miss out on? And how's your spiritual discipline? Keep checking in on these as we continue in the season, which isn't much longer. Making a conscious effort to keep things on track will help to make a difference. Now today, there is another way to wait, and that is patiently. Patiently waiting, ultimately, for Jesus' birth. Have you ever tried to tell a child to wait patiently? Something that comedy acts are written about, especially this time of year, because it's just something we do. We're trying to teach them. Now, if you haven't noticed, we have a lot going on in our liturgy and in all over our church this month. We have our Advent candles over here. We have our nativity scene over here, which kind of seems to be taking on a life of its own. We have all the events taking place in our scriptures, and then we have our sermon topic of waiting. As separate as all of this is, it's all related to what's going on. It's a little bit of what we call controlled chaos. As we explore each section, there is a great deal of meaning behind it. Just as this year and every year spreads us thin, we need to make the choices as to where we are going to put our energy. Our scripture this morning spoke on the shepherds in the fields. And this is taking place over here in our children's section. But technically, the shepherds didn't become part of the Christmas story until after Jesus' birth. So we're kind of jumping ahead a little. But they are making their way toward the stable, and now they are much closer. They are keeping watch over their flocks when an angel appears to them and tells them the good news, and they make their way to Bethlehem to see what's happened. They really didn't have to wait very long. But as soon as they heard, they obeyed and off they went. We can think of the shepherds as representing those times when our wait is on that shorter side. It really isn't testing our patience. We really haven't had time to get into contemplating anything. And it's a pleasant time of gathering our things and heading off to an unexpected happy event. But then there are times that do test our patience. We did talk about patience last fall when we went over the fruits of the Spirit. And patience is one of those virtues that we do encounter frequently. Learning to be patient can take a lifetime, though, to learn. So who is waiting patiently in our story? I would certainly say Mary and Joseph. As anyone who has ever waited for their child to arrive, whether through pregnancy or adoption, or these days just seem to last forever, never knowing exactly when that moment would happen. That waiting needed some patience. And what about that little donkey that carried Mary through that rough mountainous terrain to Bethlehem? He was patiently moving step by step. But why is there all this waiting, and why should it be patient? We know that we have lessons to learn while we are here on earth, growing physically and growing in our spiritual journey. Each one of us has a spiritual journey, and it is your journey between you and the Lord. Your journey is different than mine, and my journey is different than yours. No two people have the same exact journey in what we strive to become. What we become here is what we will become in our eternal journey. We will always be growing in our spirituality, always, here and in our eternal home, learning all we can about waiting patiently is just one way that we are working on our spiritual journey. Mary and Joseph learned much more than patience as they were on their journey. And it shows us that we too are capable of learning how to wait patiently. Our first Sunday of Advent, we talked about what to do while we wait. And then we talked about slowing down in our waiting. And today, about patiently waiting. These tools are ways of helping us to appreciate what is going on around us and what the Lord is doing, not only in our lives, but in the lives of those around us. We have one more week to wait. How are you going to spend that time? We will now